From the planets themselves to views of the solar system from afar, join me as we show you real amazing images from the solar system. Number 11. The Earth from Afar. It's only appropriate that we start off this look at the solar system by checking out an image of the Earth itself. This is, after all, the planet that we live on, and in many ways are trying to get out from under, because right now, it's the only place we can live. But there have been a lot of misconceptions about the Earth that have only been debunked because of our adventures in space. And this picture here shows that. For example, no, the Earth is not flat, it's a sphere. Why people ever thought it was flat is beyond me. And it's a very lovely sphere at that. What's more, when this picture was taken on the moon, more on that in a minute, it showed that the distance between the Earth and the moon was so great, 238,900 miles, that as you sit on the moon and look back at the planet you came from, the Earth looks small. Now as for where this photo itself came from, that would be Apollo 11. You know, the mission we took that got us to the moon? Yeah, this picture was taken during that time that Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin walked upon the surface of the moon, an honor that only a handful of people have had the honor of doing. Looking at a picture like this really helps put things into perspective about our place in the universe, because while we may feel big, if you put enough distance between us, everything looks small. Speaking of which, number 10, pale blue dot. This image right here is a legendary one that was taken at the request of Carl Sagan, a legendary scientist and astronomer. He asked that on February 14, 1990, that the Voyager 1, a spacecraft that was launched from Earth to try and reach the outer edges of our solar system, take a picture of Earth from its viewpoint. This picture perfectly showed why the universe is so big and why the Earth itself is so small. Sagan later wrote a book called Pale Blue Dot, and he made a legendary speech about why the Earth isn't as important as we think it is, and that we should take stock of ourselves because of it. Here's an excerpt from the book. Look again at that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregate of our joy and suffering, thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines, every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilizations, every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on a mote of dust suspended in a sunbeam. The Earth is a very small stage in a vast cosmic arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors so that in glory and triumph, they could become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless cruelties visited by the inhabitants of one corner of this pixel on the scarcely distinguishable inhabitants of some other corner. How frequent their misunderstandings, how eager they are to kill one another, how fervent their hatreds. Our posturings, our imagined self-importance, the delusions that we have some privileged position in the universe are challenged by this point of pale light. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great, enveloping cosmic dark. In our obscurity, in all this vastness, there is no hint that will help come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. Kinda makes you think, doesn't it? Number 9. The Rings of Saturn. If you were to right now think about what you believe is the most beautiful thing in our solar system, you might think of Earth from the outside view, but no doubt your mind would eventually wander to that of the Rings of Saturn. Ever since we discovered the Rings of Saturn, they have been a fascination for us, and images like this further cement exactly what kind of beauty we are talking about here. The image given to us by NASA shows the way the rings stand out in both the light and the shadow of the planet. We can also clearly see the lines in the rings that help give them more depth and beauty, showing that they are clearly rings of Saturn and not just a single one. We're not the only ones to like the rings of Saturn. as there are many others who like to look at them as well. If only because everything that came out of the Saturn probe Cassini, including raw images of the planet, moons, and rings, were pure works of art. There is something about these images that feel multi-sensory and also reminds me of the music of the spheres, almost as if the arrangements, shadows, light are sound in motion. That's a lovely way of describing it. Number 8. The earliest pictures of Jupiter. I want you to think about the pictures you've already seen on this list. There's been one that was taken on the moon, one that was taken billions of miles from Earth, and one that was taken right next to Saturn. What do all of those things have in common? Technology, specifically the benefit of advanced technology, which the earliest of astronomers didn't have. We've known about the other planets for centuries, but to actually see them, you need to have powerful telescopes, and you couldn't just pass pictures around of them. That's why pictures like this one of Jupiter, taken in 1906, is so important and so amazing. For it was pictures like these that were able to help quantify what the planets were like and describe them to others, not with words, but with pictures. Astronomer E.E. Barnard took this photo of Jupiter using the Yerkes Observatory's 40-inch refractor telescope in 1906. That means this photo was taken nearly 125 years ago. Think about how different the world was back in that time, and what something like this helped show about the space above our heads. And now think about all of the high-definition pictures we're able to take of stars and planets. It truly shows how far we've come. Number 7. Uranus. Yes, you can make jokes here if you want, but Uranus is not only a key planet in our solar system, but it's one that actually doesn't get enough credit for how simple in look, but complex in action that it is. For example, when you look at a picture like this, you see one color, which isn't something you see in any other planet on our solar system, not even Mercury or Mars. But the reason for that is its makeup, which allows it to be the coldest planet in our solar system. Why is Uranus so much colder than Neptune or Pluto? While many of the other planets in our solar system have a core that emits a lot of heat, Uranus doesn't. So by that token, while it does get heat from the Sun, it doesn't emit as much as the other planets. Even Neptune emits more heat than Uranus, and it's much farther from the Sun than its twin. Uranus is the only giant planet that is not giving off significantly more heat than it is receiving from the Sun. And we don't know why that is, said Mark Hofstadter, a planetary scientist at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. So when you look at a picture like this of Uranus, it's okay to think that it's simple, but it's not. It's cold. It's on a funny tilt. It has rings that almost no one can see, and so on and so forth. It looks basic, but it's not. Before we continue our dive into amazing pictures of the solar system, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. That way you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Number 6. Comets in motion. Comets get a lot of attention here on Earth, but they are also points of contention of what they are and aren't. First off, comets aren't rocks at all. They're ice, water, and dust. And they look much cooler than all the other space rocks. You see, asteroids, meteoroids, meteors, and meteorites are all solid rock, inside and out. Sometimes they have metal as well, but the point here is that they're solid. For a comet, though, it's a nucleus of ice and gases that have been formed together, and they remain in a state of non-solidity that causes them to be much different. Just as important, though, while most asteroids, meteoroids, meteors, and meteorites have atypical orbits or are kept in check by planets, comets have a direct line of orbit with the Sun, which is why they look how they do. Because as they circle the Sun, they start to have their ice melted and their gases expanded, and that creates the unique comet feature called a coma, you know, as in its tail. This coma can streak across the sky and even be thousands of miles long. That's important to note because comets are so bright that they can be seen from Earth at quite a distance, not unlike the stars in the sky, which is poetic because of this picture right here. This is a photo of the Daniel Comet, also known as C1907L2, taken with the Bruce 10-inch photographic telescope at the Yerkes Observatory, August 21, 1907. Through this picture, we can see the comet perfectly streaking through space with its tail dangling behind it. And if one comet looks like this, imagine all the others that are out there in the sky moving around. Number 5. Venus and the Sun. Venus is known as our sister planet, but it's anything but a true twin. Because while it may only be a little smaller than Earth, it's also a greenhouse planet that has massively hot temperatures and an atmosphere that we can't breathe in and barely see through at times. Yet that doesn't stop it from being beautiful at times when the situation works out. Take a look at this picture. This is a shot of Venus as it orbits the Sun. And this shot is truly stunning. You could see the surface of the Sun and all the little details that the heat and gases render upon it. And then to see the planet Venus just completely shrouded in darkness as it circles is visually very beautiful. And if you look at the top left part of the planet, you'll see a yellow outline, no doubt imposed by the Sun blasting its rays upon the planet. These are the kinds of pics that show that timing, even in something as large as the solar system, is everything. Number 4. Our first look at Earth from space. We've already shown you a view of the Earth from the Moon, but if you want to go and see the first picture of Earth from space, you have to look 23 years previous. The first photo of Earth from above came from a jerry-rigged rocket. On October 24, 1946, scientists strapped a 33mm motion picture camera to a captured German V-2 rocket and launched the whole thing into space. First of all, wow, I can't believe that worked. And the series of events that went into trying to make this happen. Anyway, after launching the V-2 rocket into space, the rocket reached a max altitude of 65 miles. Then it crashed back down to Earth. Yet despite the rocket itself being destroyed in the impact, the film survived. It was the first picture taken of Earth from space, and it confirmed a lot of things about our planet, all the while building up the desire to go into space to get better pictures, bigger pictures, and see exactly what the Earth had to show us visually. Number 3. Jupiter moving. Personally, I just think this image looks cool. It was taken by Voyager 1 in 1979, and over the course of 70 days, it approached the planet and showed it moving. Look at those different rotations. Very cool. Number 2. Pluto. I just miss Pluto being a planet. How about you? Anyway, this picture shows in great detail while many felt that Pluto was a planet for many years. Look at its surface. The way that it looks is like a truly rocky planet. Will Pluto ever be a planet again in the eyes of the world? Do you want it to be a planet again? Let me know. Let the world know. Number 1. That's one small step for man. When it comes to our solar system, there are many things that we have taken pictures of. But in terms of importance, few are as important as this shot right here of Buzz Aldrin on the moon. Aldrin and Armstrong were the first two men on the moon. And they were the ones who helped solidify that we could make it there. That space was a place we could travel to, and that we just had to push for it. This picture, among others taken during the missions, were the definitive point of the space race, cementing the United States as the victor. But what's more, it inspired a whole generation of people who wanted to work to be the next person onto the moon, into space, and for those training right now, to be the first people on Mars. Boldly go, young astronauts, boldly go. Thanks for watching, everyone. What do you think of these amazing pictures of the solar system? Do any of them change your outlook on the planets, stars, and other objects that are within our space? Do you know of any other pictures that really help show off the beauty of the universe? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.